Flathead hip replacement bearing surfaces. So, generally, from the biotribologic perspective, the situation in the joints is very hard. Yes, we have changing velocity, changing changing the stress rate. We kind of have completely different positions of the joint while walking, while changing the direction of walking, for example, and so on. And our joints are created extremely well. Our joints are created to sustain such stresses, such very hard conditions. However, at least for now, the artificial joints cannot be as good as our own joint, yes? Cannot be as smooth as our own artificial cartilage. So in order to achieve the best situation possible, we need to have the best materials for debearing surfaces. So the bearing surfaces really, really have a hard time trying to cope with the situation. And generally, what can happen? Two of the main reasons for revising total hip replacement are aseptic loosening and instability. So dislocations. Different combinations of bearing surfaces present various solutions to these problems, but also have their own limitations. So, the governing factors that connect different bearing surfaces combinations to aseptic loosening and instability are. So these are two ways how to, what to think about. Osteolysis. This is the main cause of aseptic loosening, where particles from the mainly acetabular cap produce a biological reaction that leads to osteolysis and implant loosening. So osteolysis is the breakdown of the bone, yes? In case of the inflammation, this breakdown can happen. So if the acetabular cap will create some wear particles, those wear particles will lead to the inflammation. Usually these wear particles are because the cap is from the polymer. Yes? So the polymer generally can wear, yes, relatively, of course, relatively easily. And femoral head diameter. Although larger head diameter of the femoral head offers greater range of motion and it's more stable, it also leads to increased wear. Because of the reason that I already told in the previous video. So what possibilities do we have? Metal on the polyethylene. So the more generally the quite traditional one. So we have the metal femoral head and polyethylene acetabular cap. And generally it's the most commonly used and has well-established clinical track record. So we, for a moral head of 22 and 28 millimeter diameter have been used. As a bigger femoral head increases polyethylene wear rate, the newly highly cross-linked polyethylene is harder that produces 60% less wear. Yes, so this is getting back to the idea that we taught already, that advancement in material engineering gives us better and better material, and this better and better material can sustain bigger head of the artificial joint. Mm-hmm. And what are the advantages? Generally, it's predictable because we know we have a lot of data how it behaves in real life. In general, polyethylene acetabular cap provides large range of sizes, can have posterior lip augmentation device. Other constraint designs is highly in highly cross-linked composition, revisions options are not limited, and it's relatively cheap. Disadvantages: osteolysis and aseptic loosening, does not support fluid film lubrication, high wear rates. Those problems can be partially solved by the highly cross-linked polyethylene. However, highly cross-linked polyethylene, as we told in the lecture about about the polymers, polymers naturally usually are not stiff. Yes, we can achieve stiffness, but by the cross-linking, yes, by creating the nets, but increasing the stiffness has this problem that it's also increasing brittleness, and generally this is less forgiving of implant malignment. Metal on metal. In this combination, femoral head and acetabular cap are both made of metal. As metals are hard materials, this is described as hard-on-hard bearing combination. In addition, metals can be polished to reduce surface roughness, which further reduces wear. Therefore, the larger size of the heads can be used. as generally it's far harder to wear down such things. So what are the pros and cons? Generally, there is virtually no risk of fracture, although the components are still prone to scratches, low wear rate. Hip resurfacing implants are only available in metal or metal combination, so as only this combination can endure the design in the long term, and there is also long history of use. However, although microscopically there is no big problem with wear, microscopically it's different. So we have some wear particles that are very small, that are generally metal ions, and these metal ions also would interact with our organism, also can lead to inflammation and to osteolysis. And not only local problem, but we can also have some avascular, lymphatic vascular associated lesions, chromosomal aberration, toxicity, pseudotumors, carcinogenic. So generally, there are some additional problems related to those particles. Ceramic on ceramic. Generally, a lot of pros and one big con. A lot of pros related to this that ceramics, as you know, are extremely hard, so it's extremely hard to wear them down. Extremely stiff. Also, they are most of the ceramics that can be used are very hard. It's very hard to get some chemical reactions with them, so they are not prone to create inflammation. We can achieve bigger femoral heads thanks to very, very good polishing. However, there is one big cone: fractures. Yes, this is a brittle materials, and this brittleness can cause complete failure of the endoprosthesis because of this. And also, the performance is very sensitive of implant alignment. There may be some very fine wear debris, which is difficult to remove on revision surgery. Therefore, revision options are often restricted to the same combination. Can sometimes produce audible noise when walking, like squeaking, clicking. And generally, it's more expensive than other options. And there are also other possibilities. Rather new, we can have the metal femoral head with a ceramic surface, for example. So generally, theoretically, reduce the risk of fracture by keeping the very good properties of the ceramics as a surface. Yes. Okay. Thank you very much.